Communication goes much further than auditory signals. There's body language, habit language, and many more. In other words, the way one asks for help isn't universal, but asking for help is and can be read in one way or another.
Oh, I do have food.
What do you have?
Oh, I have one of those.
Look at him with his paws there. It's so funny.
Here, hold this.
So whether it's in the way a snake is writhing in pain or the body language of a great white shark up close, here are 15 animals that asked people for help. Number 15. Snake eats porcupine. If there's ever been an animal clearly in some severe pain, it's this serpent. Check out this python who chose the wrong target for a meal this day. It slithers and writhes in pain for nearly 2 minutes before starting to get sluggish. Apparently, the snake lunged at a porcupine but instead got a bite of quills. Ouch, there have to be at least 100 needles in them. Looks like this boa should have stuck to his typical meal of bats, mice, birds, and lizards. He certainly bit off way more than he could chew. But if it ended up surviving the encounter, I bet it learned its lesson in prey choice, at least when it comes to porcupines. Boas are not poisonous, but just as deadly. They'll hide for hours until a prime opportunity to attack comes along, and then bam, like lightning, they strike. Their famous strike from the Shadow Assassins. As their full name suggests, boa constrictors coil their bodies around the prey and constrict those coils until suffocation, which it can sense is happening by the many muscles doing the squeezing. In other words, it can feel itself squeezing the air out of its prey, indeed worthy of a few nightmares here or there. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14. Homeless guy rescues animal shelter. A homeless man in Atlanta is rightfully being held as a hero as he risked his life and charged into a burning animal shelter to save dozens of cats and dogs from the flames. How was that for a tremendous response from a community member? The facility set ablaze had known the homeless man and offered services to him and his canine pal from time to time. The man, Keith Walker, saw the blaze and was quick to help. The facility claimed its owner was the only one working that day and out picking up supply donations at the time when they received a phone call that the shelter was on fire. Atlanta firefighters on the scene reported that Walker was the first on the scene and helped bring the animals to safety. The facility is in talks with Walker to see if he needs any assistance with his best friend in a lifetime service. He put his life on the line after all, the ultimate bargaining chip. Number 13. Taki's Shelter. 6 years ago, Taki's Prostakis passed a garbage dump outside Greece and saw a dog. Its bone was sticking out and just looking at him, he says. At this moment, he knew he could no longer live the comfortable life of a famous nightclub owner. He dedicated his life to caring for abandoned dogs and cats. Could you give up the life of a successful, famous nightclub owner just like that? A tip of the hat to this man who fills that role in our world, and he deserves all the respect headed his way. The first shelter started in his home, but locals and neighbors weren't having any of that. Using a good chunk of what savings he had from the club, he purchased a large piece of land where he could expand his venture further. It's grown to include over 340 dogs, 42 cats, and 2 goats. The number continues to grow, but Taki says it's only meaning that his family continues to grow as well. None of the animals sit in cages and all play with each other once they've been acclimated to the new life. Once they're showered with love and food and playtime, they all cave and enjoy the luxuries that Taki's made a reality. Number 12. Gobi the Dog's Incredible Rescue. Run, Gobi, run! While many humans have been inspired by the famous sprint by film character Forrest Gump, it's not often we see a canine taking the spotlight. Gobi was a stray on a mission that ran and wandered for more than 155 miles looking for a family that needed him as much as he needed them. In the end, it wasn't he alone who found a friend for life, one of those ride-or-die pals, if you will. Dion Leonard found the little dog's endurance and courage inspiring, not to mention they both had a sweet spot for cross-country running. When someone is looking for a running dog pet, a larger breed is preferred because of its greater endurance and pacing. A small breed would have to take sometimes triple the number of steps to keep up with the average strides of humans. Of course, this is loosely based on size, but this is generally the case. Gobi defied gravity by keeping up with the marathon runner. Sometimes even Dion needed a break before he started breaking a sweat. The relationship was meant to be to Dion, and they both pushed each other's boundaries further than assumed possible. After running 155 miles, who knows what this little fella has endured, and the life he seemingly was trying to escape. Number 11. Pocho the Crocodile. Crocodiles are infamously one of the strongest, ferocious, and aggressive beasts on planet Earth. This guy hasn't heard the news apparently and swims with them as if he were throwing a pool party for him. You'd have to be downright insane to try a stunt like that. You might enjoy reptiles as much as the next guy, but to befriend a croc is asking for a severe injury. Just make sure to keep the croc fed, and remember it has an ever-increasing, ravenous appetite as he continues to grow and grow. So long as he doesn't taste human blood, you should be alright. Since it's hard to determine how hungry a croc is, it's risky to put yourself in, no matter how well a friend you may think the croc is to you. Tip of the hat to this guy, brave enough to test those limits. Chito, who found Pocho, the croc, starved, gaunt, and with a bullet hole in his stomach, nurtured the poor dying croc back to life. Chito claims he felt compelled to help the poor creature and followed his gut. Taking the croc home, he fashioned a little den for him to sleep in while he healed. After cleaning him up, treating its wound, and feeding him, their relationship flourished into something rarely seen in nature. A playful friendship between human and ferocious crocodile. What they had sowed from a young age would blossom into a lasting, beautiful relationship into adulthood. Today, Pocho has yet to hunt on his own. He'll only take food from Chito. And whether he refuses to catch food out there of free will or lack of ability, Chito is unsure. Today, the duo even put on a paying tourist show that dazzles locals and travelers alike. He even allows Pocho to kick him in the face hard as part of the show. A croc's legs are mighty and come equipped with razor-sharp claws designed to tear through the toughest of flesh. Even for the show, this is a perilous stunt that could go horribly wrong if Pocho puts even a little extra oomph into that kick. If he gets cut and Pocho tastes human blood, well, that wouldn't be good. Number 10. Moko the Dolphin. Researchers say that dolphins are some of the most intellectually and emotionally intelligent creatures besides human beings on the planet. In other words, they're both intelligent and sensitive to emotional responses to situations. Moko the Dolphin is a character that could have been ripped straight from a Disney movie. During a conservation effort to transport two sperm whales, a mother and her calf, back into the ocean to be rehabilitated, they suddenly had an anxiety attack and attempted to beach themselves. As you might have guessed, this wouldn't be good for the whales. Humans could hardly contain and control these behemoths, so things were looking pretty grim. Then the marvelous Moko comes out of nowhere and starts communicating with the stressed whales. Could it be this dolphin sensed the stress of the whales and sprang into action? Do we have a super dolphin on our hands? The playful dolphin was later described as the perfect helper by conservation workers who toiled to refloat the mother whale and her one-year-old male calf in a losing battle. With the help of Moko, the animals calmed down and redirected themselves towards the open ocean. The workers say it was amazing. It was like she grabbed them by the flipper and led them to safety. They also claimed that the moment Moko arrived, the whales confirmed in the manner they had desired, so they knew they must have been doing something right. Number 9. Canuck the Crow. Canuck was found as a hatchling that had fallen from a nest in East Vancouver and was raised by a human. Sean Bergman, recognized as Canuck's human best friend, said he hung around the yard, not wanting to go anywhere. At that point, I walked up and introduced myself. He hopped on my arm, and the rest is history. Canuck's fame has grown considerably over the years, thanks to Bergman, who's been documenting Canuck's adventures through the Canuck and I Facebook page that started back in 2015. The bird now has more than 126,000 followers, and they all want to know what the heck happened to him. That's right, the famous bird that had captivated an audience had suddenly disappeared without a trace. Bergman still hopes every day that he returns, but it's been 5 years and counting since his best friend left without saying goodbye. For now, Bergman just appreciates how many lives Canuck managed to torch with his rambunctious antics and clever humor. More than 40 different artists have contributed to Canuck's legacy, from paintings to music. Number 8. Lurch the Bull. When Janice Wolf, the owner of Rocky Ridge Refuge, rescued a 5-week-old male calf, she had no idea he would develop into an international celebrity. As he would become known, Lurch is the Guinness record holder for the largest circumference of horns of any animal in the world. When animals break impressive records like this, it typically draws much attention, and Lurch was no exception. People from Kenya, Japan, the UK, Sweden, Australia, Canada, and more swarmed to see the massive horns in all their glory. These things are simply gargantuan. Janice and Lurch have been featured on TV shows around the globe, including Ripley's Believe It or Not, The Ellen DeGeneres Show, and 3 different networks in Japan. To say the least, this once little remote refuge went from small to world-renowned status in a matter of a few months. Things can happen that fast. If that isn't saying much about the size of these horns, then get over there and place your eyeballs on them for yourself. Many claim they have to be seen to be believed. Though Lurch has since passed, his horns still adorn the refuge from which it all started. The only bull able to break Lurch's original record was Lurch himself. His horns grew until the day he passed, so his final tally was on his dying day. Number 7. Guy rescues condor. This unique relationship between man and bird is one for the fairy tales, but of course, talking just any bird. We're talking a massive condor forced to land on account of a broken leg. The rancher who befriended the bird saw the wounded animal and cautiously approached with medical supplies, in which the condor surprisingly allowed. After each day of treatment, the condor and the rancher's relationship flourished. Once it was healed, the condor stayed in the area and returns whenever called. While the rancher never imagined such a relationship, he's reiterated that he's not attempting to domesticate the bird. It belongs in the wild. Number 6. Old man and his water snakes. This man used to travel to a remote lake to feed the snakes that inhabited the area. His guilty pleasures, he'd say. Feeding the giant, non-venomous diamondback water snake was something this man cherished, and he hadn't the chance to do so in many years. So when the opportunity arose, you know he went big. He was curious whether the snakes would recognize him. As he made his way onto the dock of the lake, he rolled the camera and waited for the magic to happen. Sitting on the very edge, a giant snake showed its face and raced towards the man with blistering speed. The man gets excited at this reaction. The snake comes onto the dock and goes right up the man's leg and onto his lap as if it were some kind of puppy. The man obviously made a lasting impression on the snakes in the area. After all those years, the snakes had remembered him as a friend and a source of food. What else can they remember, and how does that equate to proactive thinking? Number 5. Mike Rutson. Known as the Shark Man, Mike Rutson's breathtaking close encounters with the infamous Great White, some measuring up to 18 feet long, have made him one of the world's leading experts on shark behavior. After 20 years of studying and diving with the species, he says that they're not mindless killers, and all the books were wrong because they were written from a limited knowledge base. Rutson says he can read their body language and how to use his own body to communicate back. To say he's no threat, this has led to some of the wildest close encounters without a cage with great whites to ever be recorded. This is to say his methods must work because he probably would have been eaten by now if they didn't. Number 4. Gabby and the crows. This one will get you thinking about how to treat those pestering neighborhood crows. In 2011, Gabby was just age 4. As all toddlers do, she constantly dropped food while adventuring new places on their own or during the smooth rides in their strollers. Little did she know that she was forming a lifelong relationship with the neighborhood crows, and for years on end, the crows would follow her, eat the food, and leave. Get this, these crows have grown so attached to Gabby that they've begun to return the favor, gracing Gabby with little trinkets like coins, paper clips, and buttons. The crows and Gabby from then on had a lifelong trading relationship that astounded the parents. As she grew older, she began to feed the crows with more intent, ever expanding this strange relationship. She'd save some of her breakfast, lunch, and dinner for the crows, and they'd still return with more trinkets. Needless to say, these crows might be hooked for life. Every time Gabby would exit the house or vehicle, they would crow with joy. Gabby's family even joined in on the fun. They transformed their entire backyard into a haven for the crow friends. They have bird baths and daily refilled bird feeders and treats. Their yard turned into a bird paradise. The birds were even considerate and intelligent enough to take their bathroom breaks elsewhere. They, from time to time, would drop dollars. Never a ton of money, but money nonetheless. Number 3. Bob the Cat. When James Bowen met the stray tabby cat, he didn't know the relationship that was to flourish. He said the way it looked at me scratched at the back of my head that we were meant for each other. At the time, he struggled with addiction when he found the cat abandoned and injured, so took him in and focused on taking care of the wounded feline. Eventually, Bowen was inspired to write a book about the encounter, as well as 4 follow-ups, and to literary accolades and success. It was even adapted into a smash hit film in which Bob played himself. A second film is in the works again, with Bob as the star. Not only did Bowen conquer his addiction, but he also rose to fame with Bob at his side, and all from a simple act of kindness. It just goes to show you how far a good muse can take you once found, especially if you're ever feeling low. Unfortunately, Bob passed away in 2020, throwing another gut elbow into Bowen's already complicated life. Though he's gone, he claims that Bob forever changed his life for the better. Number 2. The legend of Kojak. While many of the animals on this list exemplify a special relationship between man and beast, here's one where it can go very wrong. Kojak was a household croc that was kept illegally and unknowingly from authorities. One look at this monster and you'll have no doubts why these monsters shouldn't be kept in residential homes. Kojak weighed over 40 pounds, so he was no small croc. He could still do some significant damage with those strong teeth and jaws. Because of an accident in which Kojak ate the neighbor's dog, the owner was forced to give him up. The extraction process required a forklift and transport truck because it couldn't carry itself up the ramp. The croc is in for harsh lessons in the wild when it can't catch its next meal, and all because the owner simply thought he could tame the croc. I guess it has plenty weight as an extra meal. Nature will do its thing and bring him down back to size one way or another. The family was so heartbroken that even the mother of the man who owned the croc said, "When they came and took Kojak, it felt like they were taking away one of my grandchildren." The family claims he was very passive. It would be funny to imagine someone breaking into the home and coming face to face with a crocodile, though. Number 1. The Thirsty Squirrel. Okay, this squirrel has been given a sip of water from water bottles way too often. Another fantastic example of evolutionary convergence. Look at that little fella go, utterly unafraid of humans. This is a sign the squirrel has been stuck in this habit loop for quite some time. How many squirrels do you know daring enough to not only run right up to a human, but also raise its hands toward the water bottle when your hand's in request? It might be one of the cutest things you'll ever see, not to mention pretty remarkable. Sometimes the connection between humans and the animal kingdom presents us with something rare. This is subjectively one of those cases. It offers a glimpse into a possibility where synchronicity can be achieved. City squirrels are known for their intelligence when it comes to approaching humans, but not like this. It only takes one offering of water for it to remember. These genius animals and animal partners indeed show an unmistakable way for asking for help. Just look at what's come from many of these tales. Nature never ceases to amaze. If you enjoyed the video, smash that like button and don't forget to subscribe to get all our lit content delivered right to your inbox.